not rich, one better than before. I sing and soul, sing and this is the life. And you wake up in the morning and you help us watch the stars. Where you gonna go, where you gonna go, where you gonna sleep tonight? And you sing and soul, sing and this is the life. And you wake up in the morning and you help us watch the stars. Where you gonna go, where you gonna go, where you gonna sleep tonight? Where you gonna sleep tonight?
Okay, so much for that. Good morning, everyone. So, buti na lang nakapag-prepare tayo ng ano, no, ng online classes. But nag-online classes lang naman kita, di ba? It's because of I'm still on medication. But I don't know what's going on with the dapat na solution dire kay online class. Contact mga classroom, baka naman alam ni Adora. At mag-donating aircon sa classroom. Kaya tungod niya mapasok at mga classrooms. But anyway, so dito muna tayo for how many weeks. Okay, so maarte ako nagpapa-attendance. So pag-attendance natin, I know you did your effort din naman para pumasok sa online classes. Kaya din kukompensate ito namon, o di ba? So din kukompensate namon ito in terms of points. So attendance pala natagamin 5 points pero kailangan naka-open cam. Check namon from start to finish. So yan na, ma-check ako to you attendance. Start ngayon pag finish. Oh, ito na may nag-leave na. So pag check that attendance kailangan naka-open camera. Sige, so can I request everyone to please turn on your camera? Wala ka mukhang light on. Plus one light to ko. Kung dire open. Sana all lang sa bahay lang. Bagong ligo. Para kan add to. Ano ito? Usar mo pa yung mouse eh. Pinaka-mouse eh. May pahikuan. Antipolo. At na dark room. Oh. Uy, nawaran naman. Ayun, sige, so nakita ko la talaga kung yung salwara yan, no? Cyclop. Sige, 1, 2, 3. Diba kasi dire masyado na register ang camera niya. Kadali, kinawaraan iba. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and yes, okay, thank you so much. Very good, sige, post ko atong classroom. Okay, so again, our classes is recorded. Para in a way, in record ko siya para ma-review lot niyo. And in a way, of course, this is our proof of holding our classes online. So pala ito nga, kay Kemin, online class, tas wala ngayon, mekos lang ngayon, wala ngayon mag-classes. So, I'm sending a proof to our GC. Kadali lang ha, I will post my attendance in our Google Class. Google Classroom. Lapa siya. So anyway, our subject this morning, we are back on RT224 imaging equipment and maintenance. Hindi may nama O5 voice set. Hindi may nama O5 voice set. So make sure that you are here for the entire duration of our class. Para naman, sabi ko nga, kaya niyo attendance and you effort, we compensate that kahit pa paano niyo load pag-attend na atong online class, we compensate that in form of points. Yan. So the next chapter exam, so expect na lang mga makumpletohan duha nga attendance. So you are guaranteed for 5 points additional for next chapter exam. Yay! So dari na ko na zero. Okay, anyway, so this morning we are to discuss all about, of course, that on subject. This is imaging equipment and maintenance. Although, 2 hours man lang itong duration, ano. But anyway, parang nangalimot na babatian ba niyo, am I audible sa mga nakakarinig, magparamdam?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so thank you so much.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so now let's come to our business this morning. So this is again RT224, Imaging Equipment and Maintenance. So our focus for today is, of course, kasi nga yung subject natin, imaging equipment. So punta tayo sa isang equipment na pinaka-familiar tayo. Okay, kumbaga nandoon yung puso natin, sana all may puso. So this is the X-ray machine. No? So kailangan, kilatisin muna natin maupay, kilalun natin itong X-ray machine before we get to know how it is maintained. Yan. Kailangan aram natin part by part. So sabi ko nga, di ba, the last time, quite an aton program, aton profession is quite engineering in a way kasi nga may mga topic tayong medyo nakaka-nosebleed. So the X-ray imaging system. So kung direct, kasi kita as Radtech, as radiologic technologist, we are expected, isa sa mga expectation ng pag makabati ay Radtech, okay, X-ray. Diba? Although our advice is dire lang kita mag-focus sa X-ray. Let's get to know other imaging modalities. Sometimes, ganun masusugat niya ito niya, special ng mga modalities. Okay? So, in imaging equipment and maintenance, we do not only focus with interns with X-ray. So, we need to discuss other imaging modalities that's pasok sa ating profession. So, regardless of its design, every X-ray imaging system has 3 principal parts. So, tigamnan natin ang principal. Okay, principal parts, principal components. So, we have the X-ray tube, we have the operating console, and we have the high voltage generator. So, again, regardless of its design, either ganun siya ka-complicated or ganun siya ka-basic, kailangan, and sa yung X-ray machine, there is always X-ray tube, there is always the operating console, and of course, there is that high voltage generator. Okay, so kumbaga, di ba, as a review on your, I don't know kung ano nga subject, principles of imaging ba? Kasi I also have lecture videos on imaging equipment or introduction to principles of imaging, mostly nasa mga X-ray equipment and the counterpart or mga accessories. So na-discuss dito X-ray tube. Introduction, di ba, nasa tayo na X-ray tube. This is the heart of the X-ray machine. Sana all may puso. Kasi yung X-ray tube, siya yung nagproproduce ng X-ray. So, hindi natin siya matatawag na X-ray kung hindi siya X-ray machine, kung hindi siya nakapag-produce ng X-ray. So, the operating console, bagaw sa aton book, this is the part of the X-ray machine that is familiar or most familiar to the Radtech. Kasi dito tayo nagmamanipulate ng ating mga technical factors. And of course, the high voltage generator, this is very essential kasi dito, the function is, of course, yung nare-receive nating current or power supply from the transformer it will now be converted into higher or lower intensities in or for utilization for the X-ray machine. Okay, next. Ay, ba't yan ito? Dali lang ah. Next card. Okay, so this is the basic design of the X-ray imaging equipment. So ano lang siya, schematic diagram. Okay, so we have here the operating console na side. Okay, we have the high voltage section and we have the X-ray tube. Later, along with the discussion, ipapantudlok ta kung nain din ni, nain din niya part. Ano, so expect that here we have the line from the outlet, and then ito yung mga specific component ng ating X-ray machine. Okay, so in some X-ray imaging systems such as dental and portable machines, so yung nabanggit kanina na tatlong components, yung X-ray tube nandito, yung console nandito, yung generator nandiyan yan. So they are compact, or yeah, components are housed compactly. So nandiyan sa iisa. Ito ang mga nakikita natin. This is the illustration. This is, ano ba yan? Pag-isip na, maro ma-wifi. Adali ha. Adiri ako may nag-i-interrupt ka din nila. Okay, sorry for the interruption. Gusto ko sana uninterrupted, kaya lang may mga factors ngayon. Ako lang kasi adi habalay, so lalag kasi takmudra. Pag adi, gusto niya malakat liwat siya. So, ito, wala mag-ina-expect nga, wala mag-ina-expect nga visitor, wala man ako jowa, single man, akay doon lang, may mga nanmamaupay man. So, this is the ano pala. Yes, Miss. Akala ko may, you want to say something, Miss Reyes?
Wala po, sir.
Oh, nag-raise ka. Okay, sige. So, let's go back to our discussion. So, ito na nga yung sinasabi natin. So, In some types of the X-ray imaging system, ito yung makikita natin. For example, now, tama ba yung mga sources natin, mga marites? Kasi sa NSPH, parang wakay atan era machine, ano, era, parang aton, itong stationary nga machine. Tawag kasi itong, it may kita niyo kasi UEP, that's what we call stationary X-ray machine. So may kita niyo may X-ray table, may vertical grid device, may holder, tapos may operating console talaga nga naka-fixed in a position. So tawag ito nga machine is stationary X-ray machine. So may mga iba, halimbawa ito, gagamitin ito natin dapat sa mga ward, nga EU patient, makuri immobilize, makuri i-transfer from ward to X-ray room. So ito ginagamit natin, portable X-ray machine. So yan na siguro with the NSPH, so tama ba't ako pagkabati na nawakay ang stationary X-ray machine sa NSPH. So they are using this portable X-ray machine. Okay, and ano naman, and then, you know, this is quite convenient for the patient. Okay, halimbawa, nagpo-portable kita at to operating room. Di rin man maupay nga ginihiwa-hiwa na dito. Grabe ang term, ano? May mga hiwa-hiwa na doon sa operating room, tapos ilulusad ang pasyente doon sa X-ray, maulwat, ipapaano, i-X-ray doon sa department. Now, yung ginagawa natin, portable X-ray. So, ito yung ginagawa natin. So, we have the X-ray tube, nandito yung console, and of course, inside the console, nandoon yung generator. So those three that I mentioned earlier is compact into or housed compactly. So aside from that, dental X-ray machine, di pa naman ako naka-handle ng actual na dental X-ray machine. But according to our reference, so similar in iya composition, these three are compact into one. Okay? So, here, masasabi natin talagang as RadTech, sometimes we are the most powerful people in the hospital. Okay, labi na ko, nagpo-portable, nandun sa OR, nandun sa ward. Just say the secret code, shooting! At lahat ng mga tao doon sa ward, nurses man yan, doctors man yan, magsisitakbuhan kasi they are afraid of the radiation. E tayo, nandun lang. Oh, singit lang ano. So yun, that's the portable X-ray machine. So again, yung nakita natin sa UEP, sa laboratory natin, that's stationary or the fixed X-ray imaging system. Kasi meron tayong fixed na X-ray table, yun, may fixed tayo na console. Unlike dito na talagang pwede mo siya, ano, bagat yung kariton, dudusok mo siya pakatoward, pabalik, yan. So with most systems, the X-ray tube is located in the examination room and the operating console is located in an adjoining room with protective barrier separating the two. Cheren! Okay, so yun, meron tayong fixed na X-ray table, nandito yung X-ray tube, movable, pero baka UEP, and nandito yung aming console. So this one, taken when I was still a RadTech doon sa Leyte Provincial Hospital. So we have the operating console here, nandito yung generator, nandito yung aming X-ray tube. Ito yung model, di ba? So the operating console, ito yung discussion natin this morning. So sinasabi nila na, of course, this is the most familiar to the radiologic technologist. So yun, familiar kayo sa picture na to, di ba? sa itong nasa taas. So this is in our laboratory sa UEP. You know, a little bit of information, the X-ray machine in UEP was installed last 2019. Kaya inyo pagwakaya ha. Makuri ba yan process para makabalyuhin X-ray machine. So the program, the BS Radiologic Technology Program, opened last 2013. And kung kitaon niyo timeline, from 2013 until 2019, wala tayong X-ray machine. So the students are having the laboratory, imaginary, di ba? Nagpo-positioning, imaginary. maghimon X-ray imaginary from 2013 down to 2019. So the machine cost like 1.7 million yan eh. So ganun kakuri, ganun kahirap maka purchase an X-ray machine, especially that we are in government. Tapos the funding, nakuri ang support kay bagong program. Since the College of Nursing and Allied Health Sciences, the dalawa tayong program, yung budget na hati. So, para RadTech, masayang, may daman what kami need sa nursing. So, danay, ang budget nga para RadTech, tutungaan pa, kakada pa nursing. So, ganun na, naihaan from 2013 up to 2017, ito nga amon pakikiba. Anyway, na-implement ako sa UEP 2017. So, from 2017 until 2018, it's like that, I don't know kung makarelate ka mo. It's like that, talagang makuri, we need to, dila ako na naka-experience, bata pa man ako, dila ako na-experience nga mahikilabi with the admin, making story with the president, with the vice president. Yeah, I was quite shaking. Kasi syempre, di ba kumaaram, di ba, bago palalawat ako, tapos pagsulod ko UEP, I was already the program chair, pero gatsi-gatsi na lang. Kasi talaga, kailangan nga yan at some point, ipaglaban mo't imo right, kasi you wanted the program to exist, di ba? So dere basta naman nga ginagian nga da machine pa lang makuri nang pakikiba ka, like mahikigistorya ta with the admin, iisgan ka, tatagan ka yung mga false hopes, ato naliwat, follow up ka naliwat until nga last 2018, the university president Dr. Delorino So, nag-grant kami with, 1.7 million yung X-ray machine, and it was purchased. Tapos, it took us 1 year kay waray kami X-ray room. So, in-request pa namon nga. Ito nga location niya nga, CN, ito nga X-ray room. That was actually a classroom, CN103. So, doon yung ni-request namin, nandun na yung CHED, binubungkag pala ang classroom para masugad lang may movement na X-ray room. Until, itong gihapon, 2018 to 2019, para ma-install. Grabe, yung pakiki-istorya, admin, kay syempre classroom and design, tapos i-convert mo siyang X-ray room. So, ang pag-construct ng room, naiha pa yan, as in, masakit muna ito ulo, masakit na heart, na. But anyway, yun, nahimo gihapon. So, pagpasok ito nga batch, ito nga, ini kanda chapter, ini nga, adiha picture, batch kasi ito nira Alba. What happened? Teka lang ha. Ayan, so this is the first time nga may din na kami X-ray machine. So ang problema pagka 2020 nagkami adang pandemic. So na-install siya October 2019. Yan, from 2019 October until February 2020. Successive talaga ang mga laboratory ni Rangada, kaya I was quite confident in yung batch nga. Ay, maarami pero man X-ray kay prior pandemic, sige na kami laboratory. Ako kasi na-handle dati ang principles of imaging and film screen image acquisition. So talaga, every week, pero kaya may laboratory, pero may chapter test. So yun. So nagamitan niya siya, kahit pa paano, bisa nag-pandemic, I was confident. Ito lang, di ba? Yan, kanda, batch ni Rajona. So I was confident nga, maaramira mag-X-ray, okay, kasi may laboratory na. So, that's the perks pala. So, kita niya ang result with the batch na Rajona, the Fermium 2022. So, out of the 21 namon nga students sa era batch, so, tulo dito ang top notcher. So, dako ang help talaga with the X-ray laboratory. But anyway, naipasok ko lang doon sa lecture natin. So, the operating console, again, this allows the radiologic technologies to control the X-ray tube current, voltage, so that the useful X-ray beam is of proper quantity and of proper quality. Now let's have a recap. So what technical factor? What technical factor controls the quality of radiation? Paki-message daw dito sa ating GC. What technical factor controls the quality of radiation? I'm checking. Parang wala, wala ata. May nakin, parang wala atang na KVP, okay. Very good on ka, ano, Mr. Dumana is, ano lang, a symbol. So, small letter K, capital letter V, small letter P, ayun. KVP, KVP. So, okay, so, what is the controlling factor for the beam quality? Ayun, sige, antipolo. Okay, so, MAS. So, what is the controlling factor for contrast? What is the controlling factor? Contrast optical density ka dyan. Sakaling kita, Bornilio. So, what is the controlling factor for contrast? Hala, MAS kayo dyan. Contrast is KVP. So, what is the controlling factor for optical density? Okay, MAS. So, does KVP affects the optical density? Does KVP affect the optical density? Again, does KVP affect the optical density? No. Chris, parang hindi consistent. Kanina no. Yan ang nag-yes report. Ano ka ba talaga? May pagkabalimbing. Does KVP affect the optical density? Our answer is yes. Of course, kasi diba KVP is the controlling factor for contrast, controlling factor for the beam. So therefore, pag mag-strong ang inequality, nadamo on scatter radiation. So therefore, it can affect indirectly proportional. No, iba yan na ano, iba yan. Yeah, iba ito, dumana is na 15% adjustment, na 15% rule yan. But yeah, that's technically, yes, because nga, i-apply natin an 15% rule kasi nga, KVP is also an affecting factor for optical density. No? So, KVP is the controlling factor for contrast and it is also an affecting factor for optical density. So, maram kita ang mga iba-iba nga affecting factor for optical density, di ba? SID, processing, collimation, etc. So let's have the other question. Does MAS affect contrast? Again, does MAS affect contrast? No, sir. Okay, very good. Correct answer is no. Paramati ko, pero lain nga sudyante, ang iba, mga absente ni during discussion ni ko, ni Camille. Pero para parehas lalan mga nag-a-answer, ang iba mga audience la. So, MAS is the controlling factor for optical density, but it does not affect contrast. So, take note that quality versus quantity are different. Ano? Halimbawa, for example, kasi MAS, di ba, we're after the quantity of radiation. Damo an iya photon. But let's say, for example, ito nga mga photon maghinay. So, it will not affect the overall contrast. Okay? So, halimbawa, ito naman nga mga ano, ito naman nga mga, let's say, ito nga number of photons dito ilera pero mga magkusog. So, syempre, it can also affect the optical density. So, yan, ano, that's a recap of your principles of imaging. So, we need to take note again that with the use of X-ray of the operating console, we need to be specific saan dyan yung anong technical factor ang nakakaapekto ng quantity, ano ang technical factor na nakakaapekto ng quality. Hala, I was reminded at this point in time na may ano pala kayo, may battery exam. Okay, battery exam by June. So that's part of the battery examination is of course the principles of imaging and your film screen image acquisition and film processing. Okay, so yan. So without the operating console, it's ano, parang magmemekos-mekos na lang tayo sa X-ray, di ba? Kaya nga, this is the BS Radiologic Technology Program is ganun siya ka-formal na education. So kung makikita natin ano, ang trend ngayon, ang history ng ano ng radiology, di ba dati ano siya yung mga ang mga ginpapa X-ray light, ang mga point janitor, basta kay maaaral ka lang mag-pindot, pwede ka. But yan na, informalize natin. Kasi hindi rin basta-basta, di ba? We are dealing with radiation, di ba? So kailangan formal ang pag and mag-handle ng work should have a formal education, no? So kung ano, din yung Pilipinas, di ba, we are under PRC, so regulated ang mga professionals na nag-handle with this kind of work. And of course, if you go abroad, gihapon, iba gihapon dito pera regulation. So may dinira, may counterpart ni PRC ng Pilipinas nga nagre-regulate gihapon para ano, para makagtrabaho nga to as radiologic technologist. So you have a lot of opportunities there after graduation. So ito na lang, kailangan magpasa kan mga documents nga you are really registered radiologic technologist here in the Philippines. May mga ginaaro pa nera nga mga work experience, ganun. So kung diri ka maaram, technical factor, hain nga technical factor, na control ang quality and quantity, meaning waray ka talaga, hadlok ka siguro ang panahon sa laboratory, di ka nakapot niya diha, operating console, diba? Diri ka nag-handle nga da. Pagsugad ni iyo, mga sige na expose, hindi ako sir, hey, labahala ka, ano ti mo gusto, magsurat-surat ka la. Ay, ginahanap naman didi, Radtech, ano, diri kay secretary. So yun, this is, yung ginagawa natin, kaya tinatanong ko, yung kanina, I was asking then about these things, yeah, mga technical factors, because this is for film screen, ano, film screen, ayan, gagamit kita in film, tapos may intensifying screen. So, but if we go into a digital, all of the setup will change, diba? So, gaya ng ano, gayang nasa baba, hindi ko kilala yan, hanap ko lang yan sa internet. Gayang nasa ibaba, sa picture sa ibaba ni Chester, this one. So, more of ano na siya, no? Digital na tira console. Kita mo tira counterpart, oh. Ganito lang again pipindot, yan na adin na. So, anyway, kasi itong tawag dito is ano siya, technologist workstation. Iba pa din pag ano, pag ato ka ha, even it is digital and digital kasi shoot mo pa, ano yan, pagka expose automatic kasi ada na that image. Pero kung halimbawa you are still using the CR computed radiography. So parang ano din, mag-X-ray ka ng ito ng film screen, tapos yung film mo ipapasok mo sa Ipanema, doon mo palang makikita sa computer yung image. Ayun. So ang dami nating pagpipilian guys ng mga X-ray facilities. So either which we are using the film screen image acquisition, yun, yung conventional or digital, parehas lang meron tayong operating console. So hindi yan mawawala, hindi mawawala ang operating console kahit ano, magbago-bago man yung mga machine natin. Kahit nga ano, kahit nga sa ibang modalities, mind you, kahit gumamit ka ng CT scan, kahit gumamit ka ng MRI, kahit gumamit ka ng Radtera, meron tayong tinatawag na operating console, no? Doon tayo mostly nagtatambay. Kaya parang ano lang, parang in the same thing, this is our workstation, favorite workstation as a console. And we manipulate our, kumbaga, in a layman's term, we manipulate the radiation para ang ginahatag natin kay pasyente. Okay? Okay. So, next to the next slide. Yan, so this is the ano, this is my picture. Oh, parang pinaglaban talaga ano, na kamay ko. So, this was a console that I used when I was working at the Leyte Provincial Hospital. So, for operating console, you usually provide a control of line compensation. Okay, so here in UEP, may kita natin dito yung line compensation. Ibang kong color. Ang line compensation natin, adididing apart. So, siya nag-i-indicate nga ano nga high voltage ganun or low voltage kahit ka naka x-ray ginimo mo may ginano ambot na naka na encounter na ininiyo nga halimbawa na ganun ka nag x-ray or siya magshoot so nakita mo an line compensator nga nagko-color red siya dito so ani mo ginihimo may daka dito na balik ko dan long la itong line compensator or line compensation imo yagin adjust para and if it is high voltage or low voltage ano siya in tuloy-tuloy ang supply ng nga talaga maka himo kain ano x-ray nga required for that machine or that for that exposure so yun so the operating console usually have the line compensator or line compensation okay so it has an indicator for it has an indicator for KVP for MA and for exposure time so kunaita naton didi this is the KVP so and this is already MAS na nakabutang so this one this is the exposure timer I don't know. Okay, so ayun, may indicators naton. Meters are provided for monitoring of KVP, MA, and exposure time. Sa UEP, ang ating console is, ano siya, di ba? MAS. MAS siya. So, meaning ang natong ginagamit nga exposure time is the shortest possible one. Okay, so some consoles to provide a meter for MAS. Ito na nga. Naka-MAS na siya. So, imaging systems that incorporate automatic exposure control, AEC, may have a separate controls for MAS. So, like here, kita nyo, may daniya separate nga MAS kasi naka-AEC tayo, automatic exposure control. Okay, like sa UEP, may separate at yeah, MAS ang naka-indication kasi naka-AEC tayo. So all of the electronic or electric circuits that connect the meters and controls on the operating console are at low voltage to minimize the possibility of electric shock. So can you see it? So kaya masad kita an aton console automatic siya generator at the same time. So nasa loob ang ating ano ang ating mga components. So, for ano, ito yung ginagawa ni Engineer, ano ba ito? Nangalimutan ko, Engineer Linus. Yan. Yung ginagawa niya is calibration, tinatawag dito, calibration. So, i-examine ang imo, ano, ang imo machine para ano ba, para kung this is the, di ba, take note, anong formula for KVP. Diba? KVP is, at ganito, equal to thickness dot times 2 plus constant. So, during ano, during calibration, gina-identify niya an aton constant ng machine. So, mag-ano siya, mag-calibrate, tapos mag-expose. So, pa-check niya, mon, sir, okay na ba niya kuha? Masuggest, sir, pwede dugangan pa po. Or sir, pwede i-reduce ganun. So, here, again, all the electronic circuits that connect the meters and controls on the console, operating console are low voltage to minimize the possibility of electric shock. Makuri man, ano, sige kita yung pindot niya diha, ano, ha, operating console, tapos nakukuryente kita. Ano ni sir, na ground man. So, kailangan, ipacheck ito natin, di ba? Kasi it should be kept at low voltage. So yun. So anaton didiha UEP. So this is the line compensator. Yun, ito dida. So makita ka nga ni if you have not encountered it yet, pag naman sana. Usually ano pag mga nag ako nadira ako ng may x-ray, may laboratory, mga aga pa like mga 8 a.m. kasi that's the time nga nag-aaragaw itong equipment. Ayan, nag-aaragaw itong supply ng kuryente. Ay, actually if before kasi dapat nag-i-install ng x-ray facility. Nagpapakian naman muna itong engineer pinaka power supply ng ganitong place. Kaya ba niya, 'di ba? Like kita niyo at Katarman, so diri siya nakakapagano, diri siya nakakapagalaan hospital na may CT scan. Kasi, kumbaga, ang power line natin, naka-alternating current, manggod kita tananan from homes, offices, and everything. Kaya para at least makakaya, makakompensate ang power supply ng in that locality, ngunit aton x-ray facility. So, kung if you have observed it, guys, we have only a separate transformer doon sa UEP which is only dedicated for the x-ray facility. Ano? Para we have to make sure na makakaya or dere makakompromise ang atong x-ray machine. So here, the line compensator measures the voltage. Okay, measures the voltage provided to the X-ray imaging system and adjust the voltage to precisely 220 volts. So usually pag aga mga early pa like 8 nagko-color red ito siya dida. Kasi that's the time nga nag-aaragaw in power supply sa UEP labi na yan ang panahon damo itong offices na magamit aircon. So usually expect nala kita nga magko-color red siya dida kay damo ang nagamit ang kuryente. But it ginimulate na kan dida simple lang. So it imo kamot kan tumalikod may tudid-tudid to niya knob adjustment na para kung halimbawa naka low voltage siya dida indication i-rotate mula siya either clockwise or counter tapos ibabalik mo siya nga di magko-color green na iton siya. So okay na aton power supply. Yun. Yan, dida nga part. So, mag-color green na nga ni siya. So, okay na, continuous na ito pag-x-ray. Like, kung halimbawa liwat, mga alas 5 kulok, usually, ano yan ito, indication dida guys, kung liwat, adilot siya baw-baw, over. Naglaboratory nga ni kami, tapos naabdang kami gabi. Ito indication, nag-red siya dida, taas. Ito. So, kasi that's the time liwat, mga pag alas 5, pag alasing kon kulop, nangunguli ng mga empleyado ng UEP. So, kumbaga, napofocus nila. Maray na masyado lang nagamit kuryente. So, nag-overload here din. Nag-high voltage at indication. So, ganun din tatanim mo. May dito na adjustment sa likod. We have to only rotate clockwise or counterclockwise para mabalik natin from red. So, kailangan may butang lang natin, may balik lang natin, inididi siya nga part niya, color green. Yan, mag-iilaw siya ng green. So, pag green, so go through and through light of imo pag-produce ng x-ray. So, yun, anong gamit nila yung compensator? Again, kasi gin ano niya? So, it measures the voltage provided to the x-ray imaging system and adjust the voltage precisely to 220. So dire niya pwedeng magsubra or dire pwedeng magkulang. That's why na-indicate siya nga low voltage or high voltage. Okay? So older units require technologies to adjust the voltage while observing a line voltage meter. So today's X-ray imaging system have automatic line compensation and hence no matter. Kaya nga ni kanina, naglipat ako, nilakmaaram po na yun ang line compensation for this one. Okay? Di rin ako masyado nakaka-indicate. Okay, anyway, basta sa lahat ng inyong console, hanapin nyo ito yung line compensation. So I think this is the one, yung pinaka-line compensation, yung nga nagko-color green. Kasi 'di ba, parang ano 'yan eh, parang stoplight 'yan, guys, line compensation, 'di ba? Stoplight, may mga color, may color coding man 'yan 'yung stoplight. Pag may red, 'di ba, stop. Ano din sa X-ray, pag red, ha, imo line compensation na color red, diyan ka pwede mag-X-ray kay ano siya, either low voltage or high voltage. Pero wala kita color nga yellow, ha, hakuan ha, line compensation. Pero pwede load mag-medate ng color green. Diba? Para bat stoplight, may color green. Pag green, meaning go. Diba? So, ganun din sa line compensation. Pag mag-green siya, so, meaning, pwede natin gamitin na natin X-ray. Ano? Safe siya gamitin. So, kaya, I guess, this is the, ano, this is the one. This one is the line compensation niya to color red. So, meaning, pwedeng-pwede mag-conduct ng X-ray. So, yung mga dati kasi, yung mga X-ray machine dati yan, tulad nito yun na, I use this one, o diba, akong prime, akong picture, I use it in my Instagram. So, ito, may dito na tawag na line adjustment yun. Line adjustment. So, mga kadaan, so, pag alimbawa, makitaan mo nga, mag-iilaw, mag-iilaw yun yung color red kung high voltage or low voltage. So, ano mo yung adjustment, ayun o, line adjust. Ida mo siya, ini siya nga knob, you have to turn it clockwise or counterclockwise, depende kung high voltage or low voltage. Kasi pag halimbawa high voltage, di ka maka-X-ray. Pag low voltage, di ka maka-X-ray, kailangan proper. So this one, color yellow ang lighting pag okay. Oo. Pero, more lot niya color green. Yan, so that's the thing. So, yan na, kita naton and aton line compensation, so automatic, no? And adi kasi una may ano siya na register talaga inin. Kailan niya didi may nakat ko la pag picture, may dat niya dida line meter. Kasi ka ay okay sige. I-turn mo siya kay dire nakap ini may pointed niya dida nga nakapoint ini siya ini nga part. Mga parang line compensator gihapon. Okay, so yan, that's the function of line compensation. Again, line compensator, i-measure niya ang voltage, nga i-provide niya to X-ray machine, and then i-adjust niya to 220 volt. Pero pwede magsubra, pwede magkulang. So may indication, nagkaroon siya ng indication niya, high voltage or low voltage. So the power supply to the X-ray imaging system is delivered to the auto transformer. Kita ka mo didi? And so anapin pinakauna nga ayan, may line monitor or line compensation. After ito, 'di ba, it is adjusted. So add in auto transformer. So take note guys, we are here on the operating console. So we have the line compensation. We have the line monitor and sabi ng ating slide, ipapasa niya nga diha auto transformer. Ano yan? Okay. Yan. So, we have the line compensation in the diagram, line monitor. So, what else? So, the voltage supply to the auto transformer, to the high voltage transformer is controlled but variable. So, kung nakita niyo, ano, natin diagram. So, from here, from the auto transformer, anatong voltage, iba na kaysahan na receive. Tapos, and variation, ipapasa nga di sa high voltage section. Okay? Okay. So, again, the voltage supplied from the auto transformer to the high voltage transformer is controlled but variable. It is much safer and easier to control than a low voltage. Yan, paki-take note ha. Mas madali daw, easier to control a low voltage and then increase it. Then, it marireceive naton high tapos i-decrease mo. No? So, sabi dito, much safer and easier to control a low voltage. Tapos, i-step up naton kaysa naman i-step down naton. Okay. So, see, we can expect that from the auto-transformer nga aada sa ini nga auto-transformer na aada sa X-ray tube is auto transformer. So another auto transformer is a step up transformer. Ito kasi dalawa eh, dalawa yung coil. 'Di ba? Auto transformer has a single, 'di ba? Single coil of wire, single windings. So kung makita natin na illustration, this is the auto transformer single coil. Hari kasi duduha. We have the this is a step up transformer. We have the primary and secondary coil. Okay, so this is the actual image of an auto transformer nga nakita ko lagi hapon doon sa internet diri ni Akon. So, ang mga bata pa kami pag may mawawari nga ning appliances, so hanap dayon hin ko an in transformer kasi di ba may deton din magnet. Ayan. So, the auto transformer has a single winding and is designed to supply a precise voltage to the filament circuit and to the high voltage circuit to the X-ray imaging system. Tayo dito may illustration. So, an aton auto transformer, so masupply siya to the high voltage and masupply liwat siya didi ha filament. Okay? So adjustment of KVP. Okay, some older this is now one of the functions. One of the functions of auto transformer is that again we can vary. Okay, we can vary. Yeah, we can vary the KVP or the energy from 220. Pwede naton siya mahimo na nga kilo voltage. Diba? So take note, it aton supply ng kuryente, aton voltahe is only 220. So an aton gingagamit pag X-ray. Diba? Let's say a hand. I don't know ha kung pirang iyo kung nag-X-ray na ka mo. Nag-X-ray na ba ka mo, guys? Have you conducted X-ray procedures inside the college? In our laboratory? Alam ko, di pa nga no. Nakapag-conduct na ka mo ng mga X-ray procedures? Chest X-ray, ganun, hand.
Mga nakamute.
Yes, sir. Oh, yes. Ready. Oh, kala ko nakamute. Okay, so at least, ano, kung ano na yung X-ray, Ms. Reyes? Anong anatomy?
Sa monitor group and hand, ni hand phantom.
Hand phantom. So, peran imot, ano, ginggamit niya KVP?
45 yun, sir.
45. Okay, so from 220 volt lang to ha, 220 volts. Ang gagawin natin, di ba, so nanhimuon natin ang 220 volts, okay, bago niya 45. Himuon ta nga kilovolt. Di ba? So this is 45,000 from 220 volts himuon niya into 45,000 volts. So ma-accomplish natin isang exposure lang yan na isang patient. So we cannot accomplish this one without the use of auto transformer. So matut gamit niya. So from the supply naton kuryente ng console. So, para maka-X-ray kita from 220, naging susupply ni Rosamel ko, himuon natin siya ng 45,000 volts. So, ma-accomplish natin siya because we are using the X-ray machine or the console yaon dito an auto transformer. So, gini-step up natin ang 220 volts, himuon natin niya 45,000 volts. So, in older or some older X-ray operating consoles have adjustment controls labeled. Yan, sana all may mga label. So, probably may minor, KVP, initial, major, KVP, naputol lang na picture. Okay, kung feeling mo ito na itong X-ray machine, parang washing machine, ang mga kadaan niya mga unit, labi na mas dagkot era console. Dire na siya kay parang x-ray machine, parang vending machine na mas ano, mas sa taas pa siguro kon sino ba't mga estudyante ta nga da. Nga adi. Di daw siguro kon magi-x-ray si ano, like for example, magi-x-ray ito balyas, siguro maano siya, makuha pa yan lingkuran para maimudla niya ang KVP kay para siyang naka-vending machine, unlike it aton x-ray machine na parang washing machine. Pero adin aton an amon console dito ha, dito sa ano, sa Leyte Provincial Hospital. Ano lang siya, ganun lang siya kaliit. Nakaano lang siya, wall mounted lang siya. Mga units din, like for example, nagamit yung Shimadzu ng mga x-ray machine. Adi kasi nga mong x-ray machine, this is Shimadzu and brand. So, direct nagpro-promote, pero mga painihiya, mas bet ko sa Shimadzu compared with ours, which is Allinger, direct kasi masyado kilala. So, yun, kung mga gusto, mga high-end, yung mga makina, mga Siemens, mga, ito, minsan Samsung, magat nera x-ray machine yung babalig yun. So, pinaka high-end yun ang mga hospital ito, mga Shimadzu. Japan-made or Korean-made. Okay, yun, anything mo unatan, ano? So, from 220, muna 45,000. Kung mga kadaan, as I've said, may mga nakalabel dida. Major, minor. Tapos, kung ano't imugin, tama ba tak term tatalibong? Alam mo, kung ano't imugin rotate dida, yun na-adjust siningan nab, nakikita mo dide. Okay, sige, tanggalong ko muna ha. Tanggalong kulaan mga nakabutang nga dito na. Tanggalong kulaan kay mga marigsok mo na. Ano pala ako? Ayan. So, and anything that you adjust here in this knob, okay, tanggal lang ito si babalik. So, for example, kung anong imugin, rorogin, lilibot-libot didi nga part, nakikita mo siya didi. Ayan. So, this is the KVP meter. Ayan, KVP meter. Adi MA meter. So, here, okay, so, some older X-ray operating consoles have adjustment control labels or labeled major KVP and minor KVP. So by selecting a combination of these controls, radiologic technologists can provide precisely the required kilovolt peak. So normally, ini siya nga major, this is by 10 or by 10. So pag usa mo katalibong 20, al example, ada siya dida 60. So pag i-rotate mo siya clockwise, so, makakali siya sa 70, 80. So, yun na, minor KVP, this is by 2. Diba? Kay thickness times 2 is constant man. So, usually, ang mga factor, 86, 85, 42, 43, ganun, diba? Not unless sa mga digital, nga naka-numeric talaga, 45, 41, ganun. So, here, ang natin yung nihimo didi is, ito, for, halimbawa, ang imo factor is 86. So, kita mo didi, adi pala siya 60. So, i-rotate mo siya, makaduha 70, 80. Tapos, rotate mo liwat, ini siya nga minor 6 times para maingat mo siya sa 86. So, ang rotation ng major KVP is by 10. Ang rotation ng minor KVP is by 2. So, the minor KVP fine-tunes. Not really that it, because it's contrast, diba? So the selected technique, so the major kilovolt peak adjustment represents two separate series of connection on the transformer. Okay, so kita natin di diyan, no? Atong illustration, kita na ba yun? So, duduhaan natin connection ng transformer, this is the auto-transformer, so medyo kita di. There is now the selection for major KVP and we have selection for minor KVP. This is connected doon sa, again, sa auto-transformer. Yan po na daw lang. So that I don't keep, I don't want to char. Okay, I deny and sorry. Okay. Now let's come to part pa siya. So yun, nakita natin nga ato siya dito sa ari siya dito sa duhanga, yan, major and minor KVP. Okay, so what else? So the appropriate connections can be selected with an adjustment knob, a push or a button or touch screen. Depende yan at imo console. So kung makadaan, knob pa, push button para aton or touch screen. Yan. So if the primary voltage to the autotransformer is 220 volts, so the output of the autotransformer is usually controllable about from 100 multiplication factor. Kaya that's why from 220, kasi i-step up mo siya by a factor of 100 or by a step up factor of 400. So nakukuha natin ang desired niya kilovolt peak. So if this is the auto transformer, kita natin na noon, we have a certain point na gintatawag natin nga primary winding, pero the same part lang ng winding. And we have mas damo lang winding, pero tawag na natin secondary winding. So yun yung auto transformer, but definitely this is just a single coil of wire. So this low voltage from the auto transformer, hada na siya, nakikita natin during calibration, becomes the input to the high voltage step up transformer that increases the voltage to the chosen kilovolt peak. So maramdaman kita kung halimbawa ang 220, tapos paano siya magiging 45,000 volts, because we have this discussion natin previously, the transformer law for voltage, diba? So voltage on the secondary side equals voltage on the primary side, quantity NS, tama, over NP. So depende kung pera ano mo turns ratio, so that's the point nga makakadetermine kita kung pera tiyagi increase or i-decrease. Now we can compute on that thing. Okay, adjustment of KVP. So the KVP meter is placed. So this is voltmeter or ammeter. Marak makita ko nga ibang picture. So ito nakita kong voltmeter. Okay, KVP meter. So the KVP meter is placed across the output terminals of the autotransformer and therefore actually reads voltage. Voltage na babasa ni KVP meter at KVP. So the scale of the KVP meter, however, registers kilovolt because of the known multiplication factor from the turns ratio, di ba? So, and masasabtan ta kung pira iya kilovoltage, kasi ang na-register la diha voltmeter is volt lang dire kilovolt, but on the turns ratio and formula ng VS equals VP, quantity NS over NP, so masasabtan natin kung piraan ato ang magiging output na pira ka kilovoltage may da siya. So on the most operating consoles, the KVP meter registers even though no exposure is being made and the circuit has no current. Diba, usually pag bayaan mo ang imo console, no, or ito yun yung X-ray, may nakasurat lagi hapon dito, 80 kVP, 5 MAS, pero wala ka yun yung X-ray. So this type of pre-reading meter is known as pre-reading KVP meter. So may din natin ginbutang dito nga instrument. This is the pre-reading meter. So it allows the voltage to be monitored before an exposure. So ayun, So kaya yeah, now we can explain ganun pala yun, how this instrumentation goes, because may mga pinambubutang din, like compensator, auto transformer, major and minor KVP adjustment, tapos may pre-reading KVP meter, so all of these things. Yun, or hila din ng power pairing a slide, but it shows here that nandito yung from the line pinaka outlet naton, so namo-monitor ni machine ano ang voltage, kung ano ba siya, enough, sapat na ba, or kulang pa ang pagmamahal. So, kundiri, adjust mo lang, imula yung compensator para makuha niya desired KV voltage. So, the voltage from the line will be transferred to the auto transformer. So, it will be stepped up to the desired KVP, minor and major. Okay. So ayun, okay, di ba sa console, may dito part nga talaga KVP. Now we have MAS, or the control of MA minus MA. So we know for a fact that MA, di ba, this is for the quality, the quantity of radiation. Nilipat-lipat ko. What is this one? I don't know if you read. Okay. So the number of electrons emitted by the filament is determined by the temperature of the filament. Diba tawag nga nini natin, diba we have the thermionic emission, diba? So dependihan thoriated tungsten, kaya masag kita temperature. So the filament temperature is in turn controlled by the filament current. Okay, so kasi, again, sabi dito, a number of electrons emitted dependihan temperature. So now, ang temperature nakadepende liwat kung anong ipapasok mga current, which is in turn in amperes. Diba? So a filament current, as the filament current increases, the filament becomes hotter and more electrons are released by thermionic emission. Ano itong thermionic emission? So this is the emission of electrons by application of heat. Now, so filaments normally operate at 3 to 6 amperes. Now, a correction circuit has to be incorporated to counteract the space charge effect. Balikunta muna kayo, putang kita nga da. So, as the filament is heated, let's say this is the filament coil of what? So normally nag-i-emit siya ng mga electrons. So dalawa yung phenomena na natatabo, di ba? There are two phenomena that happen during this ano. Okay, so we have the cloud of electrons around the filament is what we call the space charge, and the limitation in the number of electron is what we call the space charge effect. So here, sabi dito, a correction circuit has to be incorporated to counteract the space charge effect. Kasi there should be limitation in the number of electrons. So as the KVP is raised, the anode becomes more attractive to the electrons that would not have enough energy to leave the filament area. So these electrons would also join the electron beam, which effectively increases with MA and with KVP. So meaning this correction area helps cover the circumstances. Kung makita naton, okay, so if you can see the situation, so medyo nakukurianda na yung electron because dito yung nala sila, di ba? And it is more attractive for them as the anode raises. So we accomplish this thing with the use of correction circuit. Okay, so another thing is that an X-ray tube current is controlled to a separate circuit called a filament circuit. So, kanina natin an operating console. But this one, sa atin illustration, na nagawas na si filament circuit. Okay, so for kita niyo for MA selection, may kasumpayan din siya sa okay, focal spot. And kita natin ang connection niya pakadi sa X-ray tube. Okay. So, kung may ira natin, more likely, di ba, masag kita operating consultant discussion. Pero, natutumbok natin ang high voltage section and we have the X-ray tube section. Anyway, so connections on the autotransformer provide voltage for the filament circuit. And precision resistors are used to reduce this voltage to a value that corresponds to the selected milliamperage. So from here, so X-ray tube current is controlled in a separate circuit called the filament circuit, which is nandito siya. And then connections in the autotransformer provide voltage for the filament circuit. So kita naton, connected siya dito with the autotransformer. Ano na naman yan? Bakit maingay naman yung mga aso? Okay. So, precision resistors are used to reduce this voltage to a value that corresponds to the selected milliamperage. So, this is the how precision resistor looks like. Ito, ganito. Ganito yung postura. Okay. So, X-ray tube current normally is not continuously variable. So, not continuously variable. So, meaning, it is variable. It is fixed. So, ang ginihin mo na ito, nagbubutan kita ng mga, ang ginihin mo nera, ginbutan nera yung precision resistors that result in a fixed station that provide tube currents of yun, may kita nato na console nato, may 100 mA, may 200 mA, and may 300 mA and higher. So, yun, before we talk further, so if you are planning to buy an X-ray machine, so masugad ka kan imo daddy, daddy kasi I need an X-ray machine, kadik na ako study maupay, I need it in our house. So kung mapabalyo ka kan imo daddy with X-ray machine, kailangan maaram ka kung ano imo papabalyo. May specs kita ito, may specs. So mapakianay mo daddy. So ano yung specs ng X-ray machine? Ah, parang toy lang ano. Anong specs ng X-ray machine ang kailangan mo? Daddy, I need that 150 kVp daddy and 300 MA. Wow, social. Lupigan pa kami ni UEP. Okay, copy that. So, ano yung kwarto? Pwede na himuon yung X-ray machine. Doon po, di ba? So, kailangan, may mga specs kita ito. So, ito natin makikita with the precision resistors provided. Kung anong klase ng X-ray machine, ito yung papabalikan imo daddy. So, in reality, ganun din sa hospital. Sa hospital, sa clinic, sa school, kunahin ka nga na-deploy or kunahin ka nagtatrabaho. So, magsugad nga ni nga, alimbawa, magbabalyo. Kailangan na natin bumili ng bagong X-ray machine. So, what do you reckon? So, depende ito yung mapagagamitan. For general purpose, sige, mas mga pa ito, 300 mA nila, di ba? 300 mA nila agad-agad. So, para makita diagnostic X-ray, range lang natin is diba 30 to 150 kVp. Ay, pang-ambisyon niya 300 kVp. Ay, kutubla 150 kVp diagnostics. So, ayan, maximum 150 kVp and 300 mA. Maupay na ito ng makina. So, mas maupay pa dito, diba? Labi na kung may good news, digital, diba? Mas labi na kaupay. So, lupigan pa niyo UEP. Okay, so that's how makaka-decide kita itong mga varying MA because nagamit kita hin precision resistors. Okay, so we have the so-called falling load generator. Dahil ha. So, the falling load generator constitutes an exception. So, in a falling load generator, so the exposure begins at maximum. Dire kay nag-adjust ka from low to high. So ano yadi di ba daw maximum daan ka falling load. Paano babagsak kung nagsimula ka sa ano? Paano yan babagsak kung nagsimula ka sa umpisa? Correct. Okay lang, babagsak lang yan kung umpisa ka sa taas. Falling load. So, the exposure begins at maximum MA and the MA drops as the anode hits. Amat di rin maupay kung nagamit yung falling load generator. Kasi may tendency talaga mag-overheat. Okay, so the result is minimum exposure rate. So the product of X-ray tube current and exposure time is usually MAS, which is also electrostatic charge. Kailangan pa ba natin i-review bakit naging electrostatic charge siya? Sige, review tayo na lang. May oras pa man. MAS. So, yun. Aram natin ngayon, ampere. Ampere is coulomb per second. Tapos, add in another second. So, cancel natin si second. So, what remains is coulomb. So, MAS is also an electrostatic charge. Anyway, so the voltage from the MA selector is switch, or the MA selector switch is then delivered to the filament transformer. Ano ba yan? Yan. So from here, kakanya filament transformer. And then the filament transformer is usually stepped down. The current, diba? Current. So, diba, anaton formula, IS equals IP, yung baliktad siya, ha, voltage, this is supposed NP over NS. Yan. So, therefore, the voltage supplied to the filament is lower by factor equals to the turns ratio, depende kung ano yung multiplication or ratio, turns ratio, then the voltage supplied to the filament transformer. So similarly, the current is increased across the filament transformer that in proportion to the turns ratio. Yung nabanggit na nga natin kanina, this one, increased or decreased using the transformer law for current. So now, X-ray tube current is monitored with an MA meter that is placed in the tube circuit. Okay, ito na yung makikita natin doon sa console. Diba, yung nakikita natin sa console, may KVP, may MA, may MAS. So the MA meter is connected to the center of the secondary winding of the high voltage step-up transformer. Yan. MA meter. Galing siya dito sa high voltage step-up transformer. And then, okay, so the secondary voltage is alternating at 60 Hz. Such as the center of the winding is always 0 volts. Ano tayong magagawa dyan? Okay, alternating current. Kasi, kita natin dito, if you can see it here, we have rectifiers. That, di ba, ang rectifier, and the function is to change the, tama ba? Change the direct current to alternating current. Yan. So, kaya bago DD, the secondary voltage, the alternating current is usually 60 Hz. At the center of the winding is always 0 volts. So, in this no way, no part of the meter is in contact with the high voltage. And the meter may be safely put on the operating console. So, sometimes this meter allows that MAS can be monitored in addition to the MA. So ito na yung makita natin doon sa console, no? So yung ganun siya ka-intricate yung kanyang pagkaka-construct doon sa ilalim ng console. So yung nakikita na lang natin MAS or either MA, but in reality kung ginistudyahan na naton, ganun pa lang ay ang ka-precise niya pagka-construct before siya nga makita na lang naton nga KVP na la, MAS na la, ano. So pag-i-studyhan pa ngayon niyo. Ayan, welcome to RadTech. Kunan niyo pindot-pindot la. Kunan niyo nga gimpi pindot-pindutan nga dito, gini-studyhan gihapon. Yan, so we have what we call the filament transformers. So this is an illustration or how a filament transformer looks like. So the full title for the transformer is, medyo halaba siya. Mag-ano nga, nimo pa ininga pan, ano, pan chapter test. Labi na kay puro kita yan na online. Wow, puro Google Form. Takay kay, ganun ka sensitive with Google Form. So, filament heating isolation step-down transformer. Okay. So, it steps down the voltage to approximately 12 volts and provides the current to heat the filament. Ganun kaya function ni filament transformer. So tiyagin mo on because the secondary windings are connected to the high voltage. Okay, so the secondary winding is connected to the ano, to the high voltage supply for the X-ray tube. So the secondary windings are heavily insulated from the primary. So kita naton, there is now quite a separation, no? So insulation. So in the filament transformer, the primary windings are of thin copper and carry a unit or current of 0.5 to 1 ampere and approximately 150 volts. So the secondary windings are thick and at approximately 12 volts, if you can see it here, nasaan na yun? Ayun. So an pansinin natin oh may dania ano may dania sa taas iti iya windings mas taas nga diha primary kaysa diha secondary and then there is now this insulation. Okay. So again, the insulation, So in the filament transformer, the primary windings are of thin copper, this one thin copper and a current of 0.1 to 1 ampere and approximately 150 volts on this side. But the secondary windings are thick and at approximately na step down 12 volts electric current and carry a unit of 5 to 8 ampere. Take note ha, bakit mas pala mas taas man ang ampere from 0.5 to 1. Take note, ibabayaan na ano, ha, transformer law for voltage and for current. If this is a if step up transformer and nahataas usually is voltage pero nahabubuan current. Kita natin dito step down transformer. So usually mahamubuan voltage pero ang current mahataas, di ba? So 0.5 to 1 magiging 5 to 8 ampere but not milliampere. So for any given radiographic examination, the number of x-rays that reach the image receptor directly related to both the X-ray tube current and the time the tube is energized. So this is now the role of exposure timers. So nagbutang kita didi in current, which is usually in MA, and time usually in second. So kung may kita natin illustration, so X-ray operating console provide a wide selection of X-ray beam on times and when used in conjunction with appropriate MA station. It also provides an even wider selection of values for MAS. So depende yan aton operating console. Danay console may MA, danay may MAS. Okay. So paramount to the design of all timing circuits is that the radiographer starts the exposure and the timer stops it. So during fluoroscopy man, the radiographer releases the exposure switch or the fluoroscopic foot switch, then the exposure is terminated immediately. Huwag na lang natin pag-usapan yan kasi fluoroscopy is quite different from the X-ray facility. Okay, so an additional safety feature for another timing circuit activated on every radiographic exposure. So this timer is called a guard timer that will terminate an exposure after prescribed time. Usually, kadali lang ha, may nakikiana nga dito. Okay, again, this timer called a guard time will terminate an exposure after a prescribed time, usually approximately 6 seconds. So thus, it is not possible for any timing circuit to continuously irradiate a patient for an extensive period. So kung matapos na imo exposure, once napindot mo na, no, once nag-expose ka, it doesn't mean nga continuous an emission ng radiation. Ano? So, kung ano naka-indicate dito sa imo console, maulaan maano ma-deliver nga exposure or the time of exposure kasi may tinatawag tayong guard timer. Ano, siya ang taga, oops, stop na, kutob na dito, na-reach na, di ba? So, this is the use of guard timer. So, the timer circuit is separate from the other main circuits of the X-ray imaging system. Kaya makita natin, wala siya dito timer, di ba? Okay, wala siya dito timer sa ating circuit illustration. Walang circuit dito for timer. Kasi sabi dito, this is a separate from other and this is nearly always done on the primary side of the high voltage transformer where the voltage is lower. So usually nandito siya sa yan. Okay, so again sabi niya dito it is separate from the other main circuits but it is usually near the primary side of the high voltage transformer where the voltage is lower. So it is usually connected dito nga part sa primary side ng high voltage generator. High voltage transformer, sorry. So there are four types of timing circuits. We have synchronous, nakasync, nadungan. We have electronic, okay, and we have MAS timers, and we have AEC. So three are controlled by the RADDEC and the other one is automatic. Ito, automatic exposure control or photo timer na tinatawag natin. So first we have the synchronous timers. Lagi lang 5 minutes. Okay, napakiana sa college kasi rin may concern. Okay, synchronous timer. Parang nasabay ba siya? Nasabay. Sync. So, ano na yung kita mo may mga niya parang si Justin Tejero lang to pinapaikot siya rin. Parang nga nab. So kung ano imo gin to turn di sa nab mao ang na register kaya synchronous timer. So X-ray imaging systems with synchronous timers are recognizable because of the minimum exposure time possible. So digitality presentation. Usually, ang mga nakita natin, like for example, adi siya, mga kadaan nga pa, yan, mga naka-synchronous timers ini siya. So, yun. Naka-fraction ini tiya selection. Tawa, nakabutang dito, 1 over 60, 1 over 20, ganun. So, synchronous timer, itong ginagamit niya. So, again, ito. Recognizable because minimum exposure time possible is 1 over 60 and the timing intervals increased by multiples thereof, such as 1 over 30, 120, and so on. So, synchronous timers cannot be used for serial exposure because kailangan, naliwat. Biso ka naliwat. So, mga serial exposure nga ni guys, halimbawa, adto ka sa kuan, sa DSA angiogram, kay sunod-sunod dito, sunod-sunod pag-expose. Sa X-ray, di kita pwede mong serial exposure. Separate exposure yan talaga. Kada X-ray, iba nga timer. Sa mga special imaging system, especially sa mga angiographic system, kay sunod-sunod, kay ginti-trace natin ang contrast and flow. So, duro-diretso, iya pag-hatagin image. So bago di dire siya pwede na timo pag DDSA ka pero nakasynchronous timer ka di pwede. So next we have electronic timer. Yan kasi electronic in a way nga tiya ginatag nga number nakaano na naka-form na in number or may ano na na ayun electronic timers are most sophisticated, most complicated, and most accurate of the X-ray exposure timers. Electronic timers consist of rather complex circuitry based on the time required to a charge or capacitor through a variable resistance. So electronic timers allow a wide range of time intervals to be selected and are accurate to intervals as much as small as 1 millisecond. Because they can be used for rapid serial exposures, yun, pwede na sa mga, yan, IR or DSA, yan. They are particularly suitable for interventional radiology procedures. Dere lakay, pwede ka siya sa ano, pwede siya sa X-ray machine, ito mga pan chest X-ray, okay, kay, dere man na sa yan nga, dere pwede. But, ano lang, kung halimbawa, ito mo department, may X-ray na naga-IR pa, mas maupay nga electronic timer ang ginagamit natin. So most exposure timers are electronic, di rin na naglilibot-libot, no? And are controlled by microprocessor. So pindot-pindot na lang, electronic na. So we have MAS timers, most X-ray apparatus is designed, wala kong nahanap na picture ng ano yan, tumidang yan. Apparatus designed for accurate. Yan, control of tube current and exposure time. Dito kasi, dito makita kasi nga talagang accurate talaga siya. Yan nga doon ha. Electronic and synchronous. So for a more accurate control of tube current and exposure time, the product of MA and time, MAS, determines the number of X-rays emitted and therefore the exposure of image receptor. So a special kind of electronic timer, so tikang siya sa electronic timer, gin-modify la siya. This is MAS timer. This monitors the product of MA and exposure time and terminates exposure when the desired MAS value is attained. Kita ahat iya function, mas precise siya kaysa sa electronic timer. Okay, so the MAS timer is usually designed to provide highest safe tube current for the shortest possible exposure for any MAS selected. So because the MAS timer must monitor the actual tube current, it is located on the secondary side of the high voltage transformer. So kung kitaon mo daw si MAS timer dapat nandito siya sa secondary side ng high voltage transformer. Diri kay para rin nga aton selection, timing selection nga adi primary. So dapat si MAS timer adididing apart. Okay. So, MAS timers are usually on falling load generator and capacitor discharge X-ray imaging system. Later, i-discuss natin ini siya ng mga falling load, ini nga capacitor discharge, when we talk about generator, at yun niya masyado na i-discuss. Mga generators kasi ini. Okay, we have the automatic exposure control or tawag nato nini is photo timer. Hindi ba timer lagi ako ya? So the automatic exposure control AEC requires a special understanding on the part of the radiology technologist. So the AEC is a device that measures the quantity of radiation that reaches the image receptor. So it automatically, yan, kinaupay niya, automatically terminates the exposure when the image receptor has received the required radiation intensity. So kung halimbawa, nakaano ka na, an imo image receptor, nakasense na siya nga, tama na, tapos nakafactor ka nga ito nga, 50 MAS, and gusto ni image receptor, 5 MAS pala, tama na exposure. So, and 45, dere na yung kakarawaton. Diba? It terminates the exposure when the image receptor has received the radiation intensity. So, the type of AEC caused by most manufacturers incorporates a flat parallel plate ionization chamber positioned between the patient and the image receptor. Parang ba ako dito? Ayun. So, this is the ionization chamber. Ayun, So, pag halimbawa, nag-X-ray ka, ano, may technical factor. So, hindi detect niya kung enough na din mo na receive nga exposure time. Pag halimbawa, diri pa, so continuous pa din issue. Pag mana na terminate na, tapos na ang X-ray. So, ayun. So, this chamber is made of radiolucent so that it will not interfere with the radiographic image. So, ionization chamber or ionization with the chamber creates a charge. When the appropriate charge has been reached, so the exposure is terminated. Parang tama na, sobra na. Diba? So, when an AEC X-ray imaging system is installed, it must be calibrated. This calls for making exposure of a test object, phantom, tinatawag natin, and adjusting the AEC for a range of X-ray intensities required for quality images. So the service engineer usually takes care of this calibration. Pero kanyan, gini mo ni engineer, nalimutan ko niya nga ron. So after this, the AEC is in clinical operation. The Radtech selects the type of examination, which then selects the appropriate MA and MA laha, MA and KVP. So at the same time, the exposure timer is set to backup time. So, anyahin mo on, when the electric charge from the ionization chamber reaches at present preset level, so a signal is returned to the operating console, tapos magsisignal na siya nga, exposure is already terminated. Maano ba naman yung paggamit? Medyo sensitibo siya, guys. Tangan, ano, in specific kan imo amplimat selector. Pwede piya eh. Nag-inak signal. Ayaw na niya. So, ito na photo timer kasi ano siya, medyo sensitibo. Kailangan kung ano ang imo, parang ba ito? Yun. Kung ano ang imo, gagamitin niya image receptor, kailangan mo ito mula ipipindot nga to sa ano sa imo operating console. Pag halimbawa marong ani mo na pindot maano lang siya overexposed ka pag process mo imo image wala overexposed. So may background ako with this one because this is the type of timer that the hospital was using and ako ang pinakaunang hospital naging trabahoan sa MCA maninggin gagamit nila. Ano, nag-overtime na ako. Overtimer na ako. Kailangan ko na talagang guard timer. Medyo na-late ngayon kita. Okay, so the AEC is now widely used and often is provided with addition to an electronic timer. So the AEC mode requires particular care, especially the examinations that use the KVP such as mammography because the varying tissue thicknesses and composition, the AEC may now respond properly at low KVP. So when the radiographs are taken in the AEC mode, the electronic timer should be set to 1.5 times the exposure expected exposure time as backup timer. So in case the AEC fails to terminate. So this precaution should be followed for protection of the many patient and tube. So many units set this precaution. So, solid-state radiation detectors are now used for exposure timer checks. These devices operate at very accurate internal clock based on quartz or quartz crystals, oscillator, and they measure exposure times as short as 1 millisecond and can used with oscilloscope so they can display radiation waveform. Sana all. So this is how the photo timer functions. Basta ang iakidid to is may mga amplimat selector na tinatawag nito. Sa console mo kailangan halimbawa tulong nga buttons. Ganito 'yan. May button dito nga duha. May button dito nga tulo. May button dito nga sayo la. So kailangan halimbawa for spine adilat imo pindoton. Pag halimbawa nag chest x-ray ka adit imo pindoton. Halimbawa ano nag chest x-ray ka adin imo pindot. So maano siya magsisignal siya nga meaning overexposed ka. Pag process mo imo film sakto nim factor pero sunog ani mo film. Ganon, ganon niyo, ano, photo timer. So, i-determinate good niya, kaya lang, malian imo na ano, malian imo detector nga na-click doon sa console. Kaya gumamit kayo yung photo timer, kailangan presence of mind. Okay? Okay. Sige, do you have any questions, class? Dini na yun, tapos na ngayon. That ends our discussion for today. Di ba na yung muan paagi sa online? So, do you have any questions? Waray, ay, galing ko talagang teacher. Waray, may napakian ng student. Pero relax, sure kung nakaintindi or talagang, or namati or kung talagang waray nakaintindi. But anyway, so next week we have a chapter test. Chapter test on the operating console. And of course, kasi the memo is effective until next Friday. So next Friday, whether we like it or not, we are on online. Magamit kita in Google Form. Okay, tapos online discussion pa din. Ano? So as I've said, kailangan ma-check ko if you are here with me from start to finish para may additional kita nga 5 points. Gusto nyo ba yan? Parang ayaw nyo eh. Okay, so now let's check our attendance for part 2, stop presenting. Okay, so cancel. You open your camera. Oh, ada ka naman kuan. Ada ka naman ngayon, Usal. Pala po. Ano, kumusta yung... Kaya pala masyado maingay. Ikaw mga karigo.
Sir, best kanina.
Ang bagay.
Kayo ba?
Oo, ang bagaw, di ba ang bagaw, kailangan you keep hydrated, tapos waray ka mo mga karigo, so meaning diray ka mo hydrated, mga rigo na ka mo. So, sana, oh yun, ito, lides mo matutin mo likod. baka makikipictorial. Okay, sige, so, in a 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, okay, smile. Oh, di ba? Nagpa-cute pa ako. Okay, sige. So, thank you so much, guys. If you have concerns, so you may raise your concerns over me, over my social media account. Oh, okay. So, Tuesday, kung mapakiana ka, mawari klase, di ba? Holiday. Pero kung gusto niyo mag-chapter test, para may problema. Pwede man online. Okay, natama na, ay nakita ito mo lang. Mapapagan kita yung medal ay UEP. Wala, holiday tayo by Tuesday and Wednesday. So wala tayong pasok either online or face-to-face. Natama kita yung medal ni Ma'am Cherry. Masadyo din niya. Ano, this is, you are an epitome of a hardworking teacher. So wala tayong pasok. So Friday na tayo, balik tayo sa RT224 Imaging Equipment and Maintenance. Chapter test, ayun. Okay, so if there are no questions, so that ends our discussion and we are now dismissed in online classes. So thank you so much for joining and I hope you learned something from today. So if there are no concerns, sana all... Ano ito? Sorry, nakichika ako, tala camera. Ay, naiko, ano? Pala ko may jowa ni ano ni Rekagwin. Okay, so if there are no concerns, so we are dismissed. Thank you so much. Stop recording. So you may now